Hey, what's up, guys? Hope everybody's doing well and having a great day. In this video, I want to talk about the 100-year solar storm. This video, we're going to talk a lot about the sun, the upcoming solar cycle, and an interesting observation that was sent in by MJ Gibbons from over Mount Shasta. Looks like a massive planet, or at least a planetary ring. We're going to come back and take a closer look at that here in a minute. But I want to talk about the May 1921 geomagnetic storm. Some of you may have heard about this, and some of you maybe haven't. I want to read from Wikipedia about the storm that occurred 100 years ago. The three-day May 1921 geomagnetic storm was caused by the impact of an extraordinarily powerful coronal mass ejection on the Earth's magnetosphere. It occurred on the 13th, 14th, and 15th of May as part of solar cycle 15 and was the most intense geomagnetic storm of the 20th century. Since it occurred before the extensive interconnectivity like today's world with the internet and everything, and our electrical grids, and the general electrical dependence of the infrastructure in the developed world, its effect was restricted. However, its ground currents were up to an order of magnitude greater than those of the March 1989 geomagnetic storm, which interrupted electrical service to large parts of northeastern North America. The storm's electrical currents sparked a number of fires worldwide, including one near Grand Central Terminal, which made it known as the New York Railroad Storm. Contemporary scientists estimated the size of the sunspot, AR 1842, which began on May 10th and caused the storm as nearly 94,000 miles by 21,000 miles. Very big, massive sunspot. The storm was extensively reported in New York City, which was a center of telegraph activity as a railroad hub. Aurora's northern lights appeared throughout the eastern United States, creating brightly lit night skies. Telegraph service in the U.S. first slowed and then virtually stopped about midnight on the 14th of May due to blown fuses and damaged equipment. Radio propagation was enhanced during the storm due to ionosphere involvement, however, enabling unusually good long-distance reception. Electric lights were not noticeably affected. Undersea telegraph cables were affected by the storm. Damage to telegraph systems was also reported across Europe. And that was the storm that took place in May of 1921, exactly 100 years ago. So we're coming up on solar cycle 25. And there's kind of a mixed consensus right now on whether solar cycle 25 is going to be a strong cycle, the solar maximum, or it's going to be a weak cycle. It's already started. It started in 2019. We're just now getting into solar cycle 25. And the consensus right now says there's going to be about 115 total sunspots by 2025. I feel there's going to be much more than that. I feel that solar activity in solar cycle 25 is going to be very intense, quite possibly record setting. I'm going to go with 199 total sunspots as of 2025. If you look at the big picture, we literally live in the corona of a star. That's our position in the universe. We live in the corona of a star. Our star, we call it sun. And its corona is very, very large. It engulfs the entire solar system. So not only do we live in the corona, but every other planet in the solar system does as well. This was a large CME back in 2000, 21 years ago. This was known as the light bulb CME. It was a big solar flare on the backside of the sun. It wasn't necessarily a large class solar flare. I don't even think it was an X-class flare. It may look like it. It was just a large, very photogenic flare. That's known as the light bulb flare. That was a huge solar flare that occurred 21 years ago. And the sun was very active at that time. Back in 2000, the sun was very active back then. The solar flares and CMEs were nonstop there for a while. They were very photogenic, and a lot of X flares and some Earth-directed activity Nothing super major, and hopefully there never will be, but our magnetic shields are definitely influenced by solar activity, and if it's too strong, it can have a negative influence on the magnetic shields of planet Earth, and hopefully it will never get to that. Because if we look around at the other planets in the cosmic neighborhood, none of them are like the Earth. We are very unique with respect to our neighbors. And if Mars did have a magnetic shield at one time, which it kind of looks like maybe it did, more than likely it was influenced by a CME in a negative way. It could have been impacted by a large CME. But I want to share with you guys now a photo by MJ Gibbons out of Mount Shasta, California. I just got this today. It was taken yesterday. Look at the big sphere up in the sky. Perfect circle. The sun's over here, setting on the right, the lower right-hand corner of the photo, and then you've got this very large sphere in the center of the sky. I mean, it's undeniable. It's literally like the elephant in the room, other than it's a sphere in the sky. Well, it reminded me of what we've been seeing in the month of May. We've seen it three different times now in the month of May. Is that a coincidence or what? Remember the big sphere we saw in the corona of the sun? I mean, we're in the corona, but this was very close to the sun, or at least it appeared to be. Looked like a round sphere. Well, now we've got a very similar round sphere visible in the sky from Mount Shasta, California. There's one photo, here's another, and I'm comparing it to the sphere that we noticed up by the sun three different times in the month of May. Here's another observation. They're very similar in size and shape. I mean, they're both perfectly round, and that sphere in the sky over here looks very out of place, but with respect to the sun, it is in the same location as the sphere that we saw not too long ago. If it were to just drift this way, that's where it would be, right here. You know, I'm just saying, hypothetically speaking, why not? There it is. Is that the same one? I mean, what are the odds of seeing something like that in the sun's corona and then seeing one down here not too far above the Earth in the sky? I mean, what are the odds of that happening in the same month, maybe within 2 weeks of each other? You got one there, and then you've got one here. I don't know. I just found that highly coincidental. That was a great observation by MJ Gibbons out of Mount Shasta, California. There it is, a big obvious sphere in the sky at sunset. Great photos, guys. Keep them coming. If you have any photos you'd like to share, you can send those to reports at MrMBB333.com. All of the photos end up here at the Sky Phenomena Photo Gallery at the website, and sometimes I'll use them in a video, just like you saw right here. Thanks for watching. Have a super day, and be safe out there.